Yeah. Karen Bryant for M. Mahid. I'm here with Nick Lentz, victorious tonight over Mitsuoka at UFC 150. How you feeling about your win?
I feel great. You know, I knew that's exactly what I was capable of doing. I came in and I did it.
Well, here's the thing. You've had a couple of fights that didn't go your way. So actually the last three fights, you counting the no contest, didn't go your way. How important was it for you tonight to get in there and have a win? Obviously, I know it's important all the time, but especially tonight.
Well, you know, I don't think that the last three fights went as bad as people say. You know, I thought I actually won. I was in the process of winning the no contest, and I got kneed illegally. The second fight, I thought that I clearly won. The third one, you know, you're right. It was short notice, and I didn't prepare right. I just wasn't ready for it. So, you know, I haven't been doing the right things to get past the potential mark. You know, and being 155 pounds, I'm too short, not ready for that weight class yet. You know, so I was just like, I'm gonna go to 145. I'm gonna get all new trainers. I'm gonna get new nutritionists, new strength and conditioning trainers, and this is the result.
Let's talk about that. We have Mike Dolce over here leaning in the corner like a proud papa. How'd you get hooked up with him, and why did you make the move to him?
I don't know. He probably thought I was crazy because I just kept asking people for if they knew anything about Dolce, if I could get his number from somebody. And then through like a friend of a friend of a friend, they're like, here, take Dolce's number, because I was asking so many people for it. And then so I just sent him a random text message, and then he responded back.
Yeah. So what exactly were you doing wrong before? What did he get you to do right?
You know, it's like I said, Dolce is a big part, but it's not just Dolce. It's mentally, it's the new team training in Florida. I got a new strength and conditioning trainer with Bill Welly. And, you know, there's just so many parts that I wasn't doing correctly. And it's not big, but like 5% difference. And that actually unlocked all the potential.
So you went down and switched over to ATT down in Florida then, right?
Well, I still live in Minnesota, but during all my camps, I will be going down to ATT.
So was there something special about the way they train or their ideology that clicked with you better then?
They have just so many great fighters, so many great coaches. You know, I got so much one-on-one attention because right when I got there, they saw the potential I had. I've never had a problem impressing people and getting them to work with me. The only problem is making sure that I surrounded myself with all the right people. You know, and I haven't done that in the past. I've been resting on talent, and it's not enough.
So it's got to feel pretty good then to all of a sudden get all that firing the right way, because tonight you proved it.
Yeah, you know, I mean, I was a little nervous, you know, the night before, a little more nervous than I normally am. It's a whole new weight class. I feel completely different. You know, I was just shaking in the hotel room ready to get here. And then once I got in that ring and I hit him, I knew I got this.
All right, very good. Congratulations to you. Nice job.
Thank you.